Hello, First Christian Church, and to all of our friends and visitors. My name is Pastor Debbie Sachs, and typically now is when I would talk about what a joy it is to be with you in worship. And while that is still true, I admit that today I come with a heavy heart for all that is going on in our world and in our homes, in our lives. I think that many of us are feeling tired or disconnected or weary, fatigued, whatever the language may be for you. And so our message this morning from Reverend Alan Dickin, our regional minister and president, which is coming from our regional assembly from this past weekend, is that much more important. In it, he acknowledges the realities of where we have been as a denomination within the state of Ohio and all of the possibilities of where we may yet go. So it is my prayer that we may lean into that by acknowledging our own truths, acknowledging when we are weary or in need of help. We need not stuff those things down, but in reaching out for help, we build bridges not only within our own community of relationship, but by modeling the dynamic power of God's grace in our midst. So today, I am asking for help. I am asking that you would pray with me, that we would pray for our new incoming leadership, as our slate of new leaders has been approved unanimously, that we would pray for the upcoming opportunities that we're going to explore for outdoor worship on October 4th and October 11th, that we would pray for rest and renewal as I will be taking some time away to heal and center and to be grounded, that we would pray for Reverend Alan Harris, who I'm so excited and grateful for not just the timing, but his willingness to come and be with First Christian during that time that I'm away. He has some specific, intentional, worshipful, and forward-thinking conversations for us to have and explore, that we would be in prayer for those who are experiencing natural disasters, for those that are experiencing unnatural devastation in their own lives, for all of our teachers and administrators and students who continue to make transition after transition after transition, for those that are in positions of responsibility to make the decisions that impact so many others, and for anyone in a position of leadership during these, dare we say it, unprecedented times. The more that we can extend God's grace and peace to one another, the more we will see that reflected in the world, and we need it so much right now. The more we will feel connected through that love that Christ was called to share with us. So it is with all of that in heart and mind that I ask if you will join me in an attitude of prayer for this moment and in our opening song. Won't you join me?
Make you to shine like the sun.
Reverend Alan Dickin, our regional program minister, shared this message coming up with the whole state of Ohio as part of our regional assembly. And following this, I shared a message from the regional search committee that we are on track in seeking out our next regional minister and president. So we have, as a search committee, completed a job description, a regional profile, a potential compensation package, and are just seeking some final approval for us to roll forward with sharing all of that and to begin receiving profiles to explore potential candidates for the Christian Church in Ohio. So among all of these things that we are in prayer for, I would ask that you would also be in prayer for that process, not just for us, but for all those who are putting their hearts out there and exploring this very important and unique role of ministry and a potential partnership with the Christian Church in Ohio. If you would like to have more information about that, we can certainly provide a link to the video in our weekly news blasts or in an email directly to you. We also are in prayer regularly for all members of our congregation. I want to reiterate, if you are not receiving prayer requests and ministry updates in your email and you would like to, please, please contact us directly. We learned recently that there are some folks that had not been receiving those. There is nothing intentional there, and we really want to make sure that everyone is feeling connected and receiving that information during this critical time, knowing that also we have multiple folks that have had surgery this past week and some folks that have experienced illnesses. We want to be certain that we are able to offer everyone up in prayer, sharing our joys and our concerns, but also sharing information and opportunities, not just from amongst our congregation, but the denomination as well. Also, good news to share that we are on track for our dual affiliation with the United Church of Christ. For those that may not be familiar, this is a sister denomination of the Disciples of Christ and opens possibilities for us as far as programs, ministries, trainings, partnerships, as well as some resources and widening our circle of ecumenical fellowship. So we are very excited for that. Their annual gathering will be November 7th, and that's when the final vote will take place. So please be in prayer for those final steps of the process. And again, if you have questions, please reach out to myself or to members of our Vision and Vitality team. So much going on in the world, and it is so good to be able to look towards these moments of positive momentum. So with all of that, I will turn us over to Pastor Alan and his message for us today.
Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And now, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen.
And I will raise you up on eagle's wings.
I mean, we were all thinking it. I kind of had to do it. If I didn't, you'd be humming it to yourself the whole time. You hear this verse, and and you can't stop yourself. You may have been humming along regardless of whether or not I started singing, but at least now we're all doing it together. And doing things together is an important part of this text, an important part of this assembly. Sometimes that gets lost when we sing that famous hymn, "I will raise you up on eagle's wings." We might not always know that the "you" involved is not you, the individual, but a larger group, a collective named here as those who wait for the Lord. Does it feel like a season of waiting for you? Does it feel like a season of waiting for your congregation? Has it felt like a season of waiting for this region? I can see why the scripture was selected and why the theme for this regional assembly was chosen to be "Rise Up." We are needing to find ways to rise up. In a year such as this, in a time such as this, with churches declining in numbers and attendance, with our recent tumultuous regional history, we are needing to find ways to rise up. The thing about rising up means that you're starting low. That's exactly where the people are at when Isaiah is speaking to them. They have been held captive now in Babylon for a long time, and Isaiah offers this word to the people to bring them comfort. It has been a long, long season of waiting for them. But for those who wait in the Lord, Isaiah says, they shall renew their strength. We have been brought low as well. Hopefully and prayerfully, we have been acknowledging that lowness, lamenting this state. The low points that we have gone through here in Ohio, many of us may never have imagined. Needing help from visiting regional ministers because we could not call our own. Needing a large campaign to pay off the mortgage on Camp Christian. The need for an ongoing renewal initiative. Much more than financial low points, though, we have been experiencing some spiritual low points of not being able to gather together, of not being able to have Camp Christian open this summer, of not being able to be together in person for this assembly right now. How much of our shared ministry seems to be on hold? Can we count ourselves among those who wait for the Lord? Well, if we do, I would like to suggest that we have been actively waiting. Because while we wait in the Lord, we have shared listening conversations around the state. We have heard from the wisdom of the transition team. We have gathered together in monthly clergy Zoom calls. We have been blessed by the wisdom of the visiting regional ministers. We have had to take a hard look at ourselves, examine our weaknesses and what we need to reimagine when we come together to be church. We have been low, but anyone who loves a good sports movie will tell you that it is the most thrilling thing in the world to see an underdog rise up. And anyone who roots for the Cavs will tell you it is possible to come back from being down 3-1 in the finals. Anyone who loves Hamilton the musical will tell you when you live it on your knees, you rise up. There is a time for us to rise up. The author of this passage is encouraging God's people who have been in exile, who have been brought low, to rise up. And this rising up is a spiritual elevation to a new understanding of God and of God's promises of love and compassion and deep presence. It is a passage written to people who have not yet been liberated, but who are in need of liberation. This chapter begins with a voice in the wilderness crying out, "Prepare the way of the Lord, Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. We hear this verse echoed centuries later in the prophet John the Baptist. We who believe in Christ know who our liberator is, yet we are still needing to rise up. You see, it is important that we talk about this as a rising up. We may be tempted to call on God and ask for restoration, but I believe that the history of God is not a history of restoration so much as it is for a rising up into what is new. You see, if we come together, we can rise up in newness. If we listen to the lessons that we have learned while we have been waiting in the Lord, together we will go far. If we rise up because we believe in the ideals of a new world, we will turn this world upside down. If we rise up because the liberating Christ calls to us in our low state and says, "There are plans for you yet." If we can recognize that Christ was once brought so low that they put him on the ground, but in the ground, but God said, "Rise up," and that we follow a risen Christ, if we can recognize the depth of our separation, our diaspora, our struggle to find ways to connect with one another and with God, if we can hear the prophet's words, if we can rise up, then we can be the church that God is calling the Ohio region to be. But much more importantly than that, we can be the Christ followers that we are called to be. Because when we follow the risen Christ, when we hear the voice of the one in the wilderness, when we lift our eyes to the hills, knowing our help is coming from God, when we rise up in Christ, nothing can keep us down. Paul writes in his book to the Romans, his letter to the Romans, "In all these things, we are more than conquerors through Christ who loved us. I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God." If that isn't a call to rise up, I don't know what is. We have been waiting in the Lord. It has been a long season of waiting. But now we are called to be filled by the Spirit, to follow the risen Christ, to rise up as the church and be the Christ followers that we are called to be. Let it be so. Amen.
The song that Alan began with, I am always drawn to the next part of the verse, that God will also bear us on the breath of dawn, to remember that there is always a new day coming, regardless of what we may be experiencing in this moment, in this day, that the very breath of God will carry us on to the next day and give us new opportunities and freshness. And it is that breath of Spirit that lives in each and every one of us. It is that breath of Spirit that is described as the very essence of Jesus in the beginning of the book of John. And it is that breath of Spirit which carried forward when his physical presence was no longer among us. And it is this which he tried to explain to his disciples on their final night together, when he took bread and after he had blessed it, he broke it, offering it to them, saying, "This is my body which is broken for you. Take and eat." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and he offered it to them, explaining, "This is the cup of the new covenant, poured out for the forgiveness of sins. Drink all of it, for as often as you eat of this bread and you drink of this cup, you proclaim the Lord's life and death until he comes again. For surely I will not share of this meal until I share it anew with you in my Father's kingdom." Friends, we are called to be kingdom builders in the here and now. So let us receive these gifts that we may be nurtured for the work and the journey ahead. Will you pray with me? God of grace and mercy, God of restoration and rebirth, we ask that you would help us to rise up to stand where we see injustice, to sit and be with those who are in need of peace and healing, to experience that lifting of your spirit carrying us in the direction where you would call us, in service, in ministry, in prayerfulness. May we acknowledge that we do not need always to run, for we will grow weary, but sometimes to simply be, to be still and know that you are God, and in your hands alone can all things transform. May we experience anew the call to transformation in the ways that you would have us participate, even as Jesus called his disciples and taught them how to pray, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen." Find peace, that you will find joy and restoration and renewal, that you will rise up when and where and however God is calling you, so that when we are able to gather together again, and I hope I do get to see many of you in these next 2 weeks and the opportunities for outdoor worship, that it will be with renewed energy. May God bless you and carry you in the palm of her hand until then. Amen.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. everlasting God. You do not faint, you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord our God. You reign forever, our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God, the everlasting God. Faint, you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like